Hi, I can see some familiar faces from last semester. So welcome back. Betul ke korang ambil personal behavior? That's quite messed up. But I'm sure you guys are already at a later stage of your study, right? Am I right? You guys like semester 6, 7 already? Most of you guys?
Semester 4, sir.
Semester four?
Semester 4, sir.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay, cool. Now, before I go to the subject matter, let's go to your VLE because I wanted to show your lesson plan first. Let's this I'm going to show you the lesson plan and the assignment. So you click on to your VLE, yeah. Consumer behavior. So it looks like let's look at your lesson plan and assessment. Okay, all of you got it? Okay, dapat your lesson plan. Okay, so as usual, okay, my class, I put it in topic by topic, week by week. So we're going to have like topic one, topic two, up until topic six, which is on week six. And then week seven, they're going to be midterm break, okay, from 19 April to 25th of April. So tak ada kelas. During that week, tak ada kelas. Then we're going to resume our class on week eight with topic seven. And then we're going to study until week 9, and week 10 is Aidilfitri leave. Okay, so for the whole week of that week, tak ada kelas. I'm not sure about other subject, but for me, I leave it blank. Okay, so there are 2 weeks that not going to be any lectures or any academic activities for me is on midterm break and also Aidilfitri break. Okay. Maksudnya masa Aidilfitri, Hari Raya, you guys pergilah bergembira. Okay, for 1 week. Yeah, I won't bother you. The most I will send Selamat Hari Raya, blah blah blah, all those things. Okay. And then we resume after Hari Raya. Okay, with all the lemang and rendang still filling our stomach, then we going to 11, week 11 with topic 11, and then we going to finish off with topic 12, and week 13, as usual, I'll do the presentation for your group, group presentation, and week 14 is the revision. Okay, week 14 is the revision. Now, underneath the table, I put in the main text and the supplement text for this subject. Now, you may want to ask me, Sharin, whether we should buy this book. Is it necessary? The answer is no. Okay. It is not mandatory for you to buy. Why? Because basically, in this internet era, you can get a lot of material from the internet. You don't have to buy the book. You can also access the internet, the e-library, e-access of our library. You guys know, right? You can have access to the library, the e-resources of our library, meaning what do you call this, questions, and then articles, journals that you can access from our library. Remotely, meaning through internet access. You guys know that, right? Semua tahu kan? So make use of that. So books, books may not be it's quite expensive, okay? Solomon, Michael R. Solomon books, Consumer Behavior, it's quite expensive. The Cambridge Handbook of Consumer Psychology, even more expensive. So just whatever money you have, you just use it for other things. If you need to make research, as I said, you can have access to the library, and also you can have other resources from the internet. Okay, you just Google, then you can get the resources. Then you even from the VLE itself, okay, VLE, you can put in a lot of materials that you can read. From last semester, I already put in some other articles, latest article for you to read, for you to, you can use it for each topic. So I think it's quite sufficient. Okay, so sufficient for you to understand the subject matter. But you, if you really wanted to excel, it's something that you need to do your own research. Apart from the extra material that I gave you in the VLE, you can also do your own research. Okay, so it really up to you. Okay, really up to you. I think I have teach consumer behavior for the past 3 semester. This semester, I think, in my 4th semester, teaching this subject, and nobody got A for this subject. I don't know why. The most that they get is A minus. I hope you guys can break the tradition by getting the A's for consumer behavior. I really, really wanted to give, but I don't know. Nobody got it. So, any questions about the lesson and assessment plan? You going to be assessed by coursework and final exam. There's no midterm exam. Okay, no midterm exam, meaning 20 marks will come from your individual assignment, and 40 will come from your group assignment. Okay, if no question, I'll go to the assignments. Ada tak? Is there any questions? Ada soalan? Tak ada? Sure?
Tak ada, sir.
Tak ada, sir.
So far, not yet.
So far, not yet. Seperti biasa, nanti aku akan tanya soalan dan aku akan jawab. I preempt what you wanted to ask, then I ask, and then I answer that question. Hey, korang, tak berubah. Okay, now you go back to your consumer behavior. Click on the assignment. I wanted to go through your individual assignment first. Okay, click your individual assignment. Okay, if you click your individual assignment, there are 2 attachments then. One is Angrynomics, second one is the actual question. Okay, the Angrynomics by Eric Lonergan, that attachment is not the actual text. The attachment is the newspaper reporting about that book. Okay, so you click at the CB individual assignment January 2021, PDF 4. Okay, you click that one first. That's the main question. Okay, that's the main question. All right, got it. Dapat?
Sorry, saya kat mana eh? Kat VLE ke?
Dekat VLE, dekat assignment. 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 Then you click individual assignment. From that individual assignment, you click that apa ni, CB individual assignment January 2021 attachment. Then it will takes you to the main question. The question. Dapat tak? Muhammad Adli. Dapat? Yang lain dapat?
Dapat, sir.
Dapat,
okay. Dapat, sir.
Okay. Now, there are 8 questions. Okay, with 100 marks. Total of 100 marks. So, 8 questions. But that question basically from the same text. Okay, maksudnya from the book Angrinomics by Eric Lonergan and Mark Blyth. Okay, Agenda Publishing 2020. Now, all that 8 question basically giving you the that is question, but the question I taken up from that book. Okay, Angrinomics by Eric Lonergan and Mark Blyth ni is about, it's not they never say that it is a consumer behavior subject. It's just that Lonergan and Blyth in that book Angrinomics talking about the state of our society right now. Okay, the state of our society right now, which are angry. I can see which I can resonate with that. Every time I no, now social media is like a toxic place, no? You go to Twitter, you go to Facebook, very toxic. I can see a lot of hatred in Twitter, in Facebook. No, sampai bola pun boleh jadi gaduh. I do not know why, you know. No, people get angry easily nowadays. I do not know why. Okay. But then this book, Angrinomics, they discuss why people become angry. Then it not just because from the consumer or from the behavior point of view, society now become very angry because a lot of factors, because of the social factors, because of the economic factors, because of the political factors, which is all interrelated. Okay, although they are talking in terms of what happened in the Europe and the US, but it's something that can be, you know, it can maybe relevant to Malaysian context as well. Okay, why? Because when we talk about when people angry about the economy, well, they're not angry because why Malaysian or that country, their country economy is not good, not that good, but they angry because bad economy meant bad employment. People do not have employment, or even they have been employed, they may not get a satisfactory salary. You can see now fresh graduates talking about, you know, getting a meager salary, 1,200, 1,300 or 1,500 basic salary. We're talking about inequality of wealth. For example, like you can see there's a golongan kayangan, golongan marhain in Malaysia. So those are, whenever they're talking about golongan marhain, they're talking about golongan kayangan. That is a indication of inequality of wealth distribution. That is the indicator of have and have nots. The gap between the have and have nots. The gap between the T20 and the bottom 40. And this dissatisfaction, or you can see from the social media, and people can get easily angry, okay, with that. So the question 1 until 8, okay, is asking you about, basically they're asking you about that society, how society in our time right now can get easily angry. For example, question number 1, when you have people who are angry, then you have tribes. And then how the strikes can be easily manipulated by politicians. Then you ask me, Sharin, why la talking about politics in consumer behavior? Well, it's all interrelated. That behavior, the society's behavior are all interrelated, related by the economics, related by the social, related by the politics. So for this subject, you need to open up your horizon, your mind. Why? Because when we talk about behavior and things which influence behavior, you can find that behavior can be influenced by multiple factors. So you need to understand about the economics. You need to understand about the sociopolitics. You need to understand about the economics and political factors which influence the human behavior. Okay, because our subject is about consumer behavior. So you need to understand what influence the behavior of these consumers. Okay. And then number three, for example, how economics and political changes driven in part by technology and demography generate the micro side of agronomics. So these you can see that behavior can be influenced by political changes, by technology, and changes in demographic. Okay, meaning, for example, you have migrates, people who migrates from another country to another country. For example, like when you have this sentiment against migrants, for Bangladeshi and Indonesians, for example. So whereby we have this xenophobia. Okay, xenophobia means we a phobia against people who came from another country. These are the things which influence the behavior in consumer behavior in Malaysia, okay, and in the rest of the world. Public policy issues. How does that influence consumer behavior? Okay. Underlying values. What the meaning of underlying value? And the last question is about mainstream media. How people are now no longer trust mainstream media. Okay, how do you improve that? Why? Because the moment you have distrust of mainstream media, for example, like the television, newspaper, you know that, then you believe more on whatever in the internet. So what's the problem with this? The problem when you have this infodemic, or you have fake news, okay, where people supply fake news. And because you don't believe in mainstream media, you believe more whatever you read in the internet, whatever you read in the WhatsApp group, whatever been forwarded to you in the WhatsApp group. This may it is a democratize information, okay, but it also lead away for fake news. It also lead ways for people to feeding seeds of hatred. Okay, I got a lot of people who send me hatred through WhatsApp. Sampai saya kena block. Saya block those people from sending me any messages. Well, because every day send me all these hate messages. Bukan hate against me. Hate against other people. Hate against any political parties, you know that. Hatred against other individuals. So all this, okay, hatred flying around through the internet, you know that. So it causes people to be angry. Okay. So for this question, the suggested reading is Angrynomics. Okay. Okay, sorry about that. So you can read this book. Okay. The other attachment is the newspaper reporting about that book. So it's not the actual book. You can also attempt to answer this question without reading this book. No problem as well. But I would suggest that you may wanted to read this book. Okay. Not because of anything, because it open up your mind horizon. Okay. It's something that, hey, look, this is what going on in our society. And it influenced the behavior. It influenced our behavior. Why we become so angry all the time? Apa kita selalu marah-marah? Something sikit je benda trigger, dah marah. You go to the Twitter or the net. No, what is this? What happened to our society right now? Okay. Right, the instruction is to submit the written answer on or before 11th of April. Okay, you got like 1 month plus to answer this question. You can submit through the VLE. Okay, answer can be in pages, words or PDF format. Plagiarism is prohibited. Answer from is prohibited. Assisting your friend to by providing your answer also prohibited. I caught anyone doing this, I give 0 marks for your assignment. For those who are copy and the one who give his or her friend to copy. Why is this? Because I need to be tough. Last semester, I caught some student, consumer behavior student, were cheating, copying from each other. I still give leeway for like, I just deduct 10 marks. But at the end of the semester, I caught 7 of my master's student doing the same thing for their final exam. Then I said, what happened to this student? Okay. Even master student got answers from each other, not for assignment, for final exam. I said, this is the last straw. Okay, something need to be done. I need to stamp out this bad behavior. So from this semester now on, I caught anyone copying from each other, 0 straight away. No, basically, then you might want to ask, exact copy each other, bukannya anything serious. Ni soalan exam pun, soalan kubur pun dah lama bin apa, dah bocor lama dah boleh copy from each other jawapan. But well, this something got to do with ethics lah, right? You see that in our society, or with all this corruption, all this abuse of powers, you know that, because of we always think that it is a small thing. You just because you pray 5 times a day, it doesn't mean that you have the leeway to cheat during exam. Cheating is cheating, okay? Stealing is stealing. No, there's no degree of kalau curi jawapan orang lain, darjah apa kedosaan itu ada amat rendah. So it's okay to cheat during exam. It's okay to cheat for the assignment. Sebab kalau masuk neraka pun mungkin tak neraka yang paling bawah, mungkin neraka yang yang CPCP sahaja. So don't go to that. Okay, don't go to that. Cheating is cheating, ethical and unethical. So don't go to that. Don't choose that path. If these small things like exams and assignments, you cannot be ethical when you go out there, I don't know. Okay, that's the root of all the corruptions and abuse of power that we have right now in this world. So I won't tolerate this. Okay. Your advice to start working on this assignment early, because the question is quite tough. Okay, it's quite general and it's quite tough. It requires your it requires a very deep thinking about the subject matter. This is not something that you can do the night before 11th of April. Okay. Kalau awak nak lupakan soalan ni sampai 10 bulan April, malam tu baru nak buat, I don't think you will be able to answer this question satisfactorily. Meaning you can answer, but your answer may not be to that standard. So I would advise you to work on this question early. The book, okay, the book. You have the choice of buying the book, or you can like get someone to you share among yourself. There are like 15 or 16 or 14 of you here, or maybe more. You guys can chip in, buy one book, and get one person to copy and scan, put it in, and share it among yourself. It's one week. Maksudnya, since buku ni bukan buku aku, alright, so I don't get any royalty from this. But for the purpose of education, okay, for the purpose of education, you may someone get someone to buy this book, or you guys chip in, okay, you guys chip in among yourself. And get someone to scan and share it with all of you. Okay, I think that would be the best way to save your resources. Okay. Ataupun ada siapa-siapa yang boleh dapat from the internet, dapat the whole book, for example. I'm not sure how. It's up to you guys. How to do it. Right. Any questions about your individual assignment? Buku tu tak besar pun, it's like it's about this thick, alright, about this thick. Okay, kalau awak baca maybe one or two days, habis. Okay. Okay, any question? Ada soalan?
No sir.
Tak ada. Okay, alright. So I wanted to talk about your group assignment. So click on your group assignment under title assignment, then you click on the group assignment January semester. Okay. Click the attach, it takes you to the question. Okay. Now, everyone got it? Semua dah dapat ke?
Dah, sir.
Dah, sir.
Okay. Group assignment, you are a marketing professional now. You need to work within two or four members. Okay. Minimum two, maximum four. Why I'm not fussy about the number, because not many of you. Okay, consumer behavior tak ramai. Dalam 16 orang ke macam tu. Okay, as at this morning. So your members can be minimum two. Okay, you cannot work on your own. Seorang-seorang bukan group. Seorang-seorang tu individual. So you need to have minimum two, maximum four. And then you need to come up with a report. Okay, a report on solution to marketing problems. Okay, solution to marketing problems. I leave it to you. What are the problems in marketing that you wanted to conduct survey or experiment on? I leave it to you. Okay. For example, the topic should meet, but the topic, okay, the topic that you choose must meet the following requirement. It should be a consumer behavior phenomenon related either to the acquisition, consumption, or disposal of a product or okay. It can be a pre-purchase phenomenon, a purchase phenomenon, or post-purchase phenomenon, or a combination of these. Okay. It can also focus on the reducing consumption. For example, you try to get people to reduce cigarette intakes, for example, sugary, soft drink, texting while driving, or how to get people to not to use plastic or plastic straw, for example. So that is your research. That is your research. Whatever your research is, it need to have managerial or public policy relevance, meaning to say it need to have some implication on the industry, something that you can use it outside. Bukannya you buat some research which it has no industry relevant, tak ada kepentingan langsung, tak ada, for example, like apakah how to get people to eat Oreo ice cream, for example. What is the relevant of that? Kalau awak dapat orang makan Oreo ice cream, so what? So that your research or experiment need to have a managerial or public policy relevant. Macam contoh, you wanted to reduce plastic consumption, for example. It has a relevancy on public policy. Okay, it's good for the environment, you know that. Your report need to able to increase our understanding of an aspect of consumer behavior in ways that can benefit firms and or consumers. So what is the research? I leave it to you. Okay, to think. Okay, it can be pre-purchase, post-purchase. What are the things that, what are the problems that you wanted to research on? So I leave it to you. Okay, I leave it to you. But whatever you wanted to do, it must be feasible lah. You don't try to do research which can span like 1 year. You don't have 1 year. You don't have that time. Whatever research, whatever experiment you wanted to do, it must be completed within 1 semester, okay? Because you need to send your report on week 13. Alright. Any question? Ada soalan tak? Soalan. Format, I give it the format already. What you need to cover in your report. Part 1, part 2. You know that. Okay, ada any question, any soalan regarding individual assignment?
I have a question.
Siapa tu?
I have to open my camera. Hold on, let me open this. Yeah. Okay.
Nur Ainatul Afrina, is it? Okay.
Hey. Hi, sir.
Yes.
It's been a while since we meet.
Yes,
we meet again.
Come back to my class.
Yeah, we meet again. Okay, so my question is about regarding group assignment. Can you ask us to find solution to marketing problem? Is it any kind of marketing problem, or you will provide?
Any kind. I leave it to you. Okay. Why? Because you are at the later stage of your study already. I'm sure that you have learned marketing subject from other subject before this, and I'm sure that from your experience you know that okay, this is some problem that you wanted to know. What is the question? What the answer? Okay, what is the answer to this? For example, let's say one day you see that let's say Malaysian is so addicted to plastic bags, for example. Why Malaysian is so addicted to plastic bags? Every time go to supermarket, not plastic bag. Every time not plastic bag. Okay, so ataupun ada dah beli dah apa ni recycle bag, tapi selalu lupa nak bawa. So macam mana nak selesaikan masalah tu? So ataupun right now you see a lot of people wearing mask, kan? Dia pakai mask, keluar dia pakai mask. Lepas tu dah habis, buang. They just throw it away. So I'm sure by the end of this year, after 2 years of MCO and this pandemic, I'm sure there's a lot of disposable masks in our dump site. What can we do about that? What can we do about that? So how can we reduce this wastage? That is one question. Ada juga, but you may wanted to do something else. So I leave it to. Okay, I leave it to you. To some of the problems that you may think that it is interesting to you. Okay, Nur Ainatul Aqim.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Any other question? Ada soalan lain yang terbuku di hati anda yang ingin anda luahkan? Hana Bashira, ada soalan? Hana Bashira, where
so far no answer.
Ya ke? Tak ada.
Belum lagi setakat ni.
Awak daripada last semester tak ada soalan?
Sorry.
Okay guys, kalau tak ada soalan, can I dive into the subject matter today? Our lecture today, can I?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, you go to your VLE. Okay. And then go to the first topic, framework for consumer analysis. Okay, for those who have been to my other classes before, you know how I conduct my lecture or classes. For those who are new, okay, I won't share the slides on my screen. Why? Because I want you to go to your VLE. At least you can see what is there in the VLE. Okay, I can't understand those students who never been to their VLE before. Apa ni, nota-nota semua kawan dia yang printkan untuk dia. Sangat beruntung. Semasa student pun dah ada PA. Right now, then for every week, okay, except for this week. So I'll give lectures for this week, and then at the end of the lecture, I will tell you, okay, next week we're going to discuss about a case study. So that case study will be discussed the next week, the following week. Okay, so this week tak adalah. Okay, but this is the first week. So at the framework for consumer analysis, at the first topic, you see CB introduction. Nampak tak CB introduction? You click that one. That is our slide for today. CB introduction. Got it?
Dapat, sir.
Okay. Sekejap. Mine is still loading. While waiting for this, you guys have any problem with your internet?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I got that problem, the same problem from time to time. But then if you got any problem with the internet, okay, I will record each session, then you can look at the recorded session again at your VLE. Okay. Right now, consumer behavior, foundations of consumer behavior. I prepared this slide last semester, but still relevant. Yeah. Now, you go to the next slide. Okay, person who identify what is consumer. Okay, we start our topic with determining who is a consumer. So, a consumer. Okay, consumer is person who identify a need or desire, makes a purchase and then dispose of the product during the three stages of consumption process. Remember just now when we talk about your group assignment, okay? I asked you to find any problems on pre-purchase, purchase and post-purchase stages, right? So basically, consumer gone to this piece. For example, like you buy a Coca-Cola, okay? You buy a Coca-Cola drink. So there is a pre-purchase, meaning before you buy the Coca-Cola, what do you do? Okay, before you buy, where do you get your information about that tin of Coca-Cola? And then you actually purchase that Coca-Cola. Where do you purchase that Coca-Cola? Why do you choose that channel to purchase the Coca-Cola? Okay, those are the questions. And then after you drink Coca-Cola, the tin, okay, the can, how do you dispose that tin of Coca-Cola? Do you go for recycle? Or you just dump it anywhere? Or do you convert it into other things? For example, you convert it into, let's say, what do you call this? You put your pen and pencil, you know that. Or you convert it into a pasu, a pot. Okay, so those are the consumption processes. Meaning to say, when we talk about behavior, we talk about consumer behavior, we talk about these processes. How consumer behave in these three stages. Okay, so it may be the same as whatever you have learned from the other subject. Okay, but for consumer behavior, we focusing on the behavior of the consumer at these three stages. Mm-hmm. Fajaria, do you follow the lesson, Fajaria? Fajaria. Fajaria. Fifi Nuriati?
Yes, sir, I'm here.
Ah, okay. Right. Because I think there's some technical problem there. Fifi Nuriti. How do I pronounce your name, Fifi?
Fifi Nuriti.
Fifi Nuriti.
Saya on off camera sir. Kalau on camera kadang-kadang internet slow.
Okay. I'm okay with it. Meaning to say, on and off tu saya tak ada masalah as long as you still in the lesson. But then kalau awak rasa macam slow tu awak off lah kan, tapi you still in the class. Okay, but then when I ask you, then as long as you answer my question should be okay.
Okay. Yeah,
Fifi Nuriti.
Yes.
Okay, right. Now you go to the next slide. An introduction to consumer behavior. So what are we going to study in consumer behavior in the next 14 weeks, what are we going to focus on for in this topic, in this subject, okay, consumer behavior. So what we're going to look at is the process, consumer behavior as a process. business behavior, but we're not going to talk about business behavior. We're going to talk about people's behavior, person, individual behavior. And under people, we have this tribes. Tribes meaning groups of people who may share the same interests, or what we call tribes. Okay, the in thing right now, the latest terminology, tribes. We are always been lumped together in, okay, and then we going to look at the demographic, and we also going to look at the segmentation strategies, okay, based on the behavior of the consumer. How do we segmentize our consumer based on their behavior? Okay. Then we go talk about choices. What makes people choose brand A, not brand B? Why people detest brand C? Kenapa orang tak suka brand C? Okay, so those are the things. What makes a choice choosing that brand, not the other brand? Okay. So we going to look at that structurally. And then we go to talk about needs and wants. What causes people to need something? What causes people to want something? Okay, we're going to look at the behavior side of it. Because for other subject, we talk about marketing is about satisfying needs and wants, correct? But for consumer behavior, we're going to look at why people need something, why people want something. Okay, now the question is, why should we understand why people choose A and not B? Okay, so that, why should we learn about that? In consumer behavior, we learn about why people choose something, why people not choosing something. Because when you do marketing strategy, you need to understand the behavior. You need to understand why people choose something. What triggers a person to like a brand? And then you use that to your marketing strategy. So that's why you need to learn about the consumer behavior. Okay, the psychological part of it. Because not all. Okay. We think that we are rational, but sometimes we acted based on irrational things. For example, like why people put in what they call it, candies, chewing gum at the counter. For example, you go to the 7-Eleven, right? Or any Speed 99 ke, kenapa dekat kedai-kedai tu at the counter, dekat depan kaunter tu dia letak chewing gum, letak candies. Kenapa? Because those product we buy based on impulse. Okay? Pernahkah awak pergi 7-Eleven ataupun Speed 99 semata-mata nak beli chewing gum? Semata-mata nak beli candies. Semata-mata nak beli coklat. Coklat buat yang kecil-kecil. Tak ada kan, awak mungkin nak beli roti gardenia, awak nak beli gula, awak nak beli beras. And then awak pergi ke Speed 99, awak beli beras. For example, you take beras daripada Speed 99. Then you go towards the counter nak bayar. Then awak nampak chewing gum. So awak kata, oh okay, nak chewing gum ni nampak best. So awak ambil chewing gum. Impulse buying, right? So that is, how do you explain that? Okay, because if you are a rational person, it doesn't explain your impulse buying. Impulse buying is something which come to you in the spur of the moment. So you make decision sometimes not because of rational deduction, not because of something that you about it. Sometimes you just do it automatically. For example, like you're driving. Every day you drive to your work, to your office, for example. You take the same route. Okay, you take the same route every day. So I would guarantee after 1 month or after 2 months, you do it, you go to the office automatically. You don't really think jalan apa nak guna. You nak guna jalan Sultan Ismail ke, nak guna jalan Tun Razak ke. It goes by automatic. It's automatic. You got that memory, then that memory just goes automatic. Is it rational? What how do you explain that in psychological? Is there any sort of psychological explanation to that? Nothing. It's something like which is just there in your mind. It goes by automatic. It goes by heart. Okay, awak tak fikir pun nak guna jalan apa, but awak just gunakan jalan tersebut. The same thing as kalau awak pergi ke, let's say you go to the bathroom after this. Let's say your bathroom quite slippery, right? Then awak tergelincir, you slip, okay? You about to fall. And then your tangan pergi mencapai apa saja yang boleh dicapai. Does it involve any thinking at that point of time? Or is it automatic? So those are the things which we're going to learn. Okay? We're going to learn about how the mechanics of our mind, the mechanics of our behavior. So perhaps when understanding that behavior, that you understand the behavior of the consumer, then you can use that in your marketing strategy. What colors that people like? Gambar apa yang people like? What triggers? Kalau gunakan color biru, apa pemahaman orang? What was the perception for blue color? What is the perception of red color? Those are the things that we going to understand. And then differing perspective on understanding consumer behavior. So of course, when we talk about psychology, when we research on the behavior, there's a lot of researcher, there's a lot of philosophy, there's a lot of school of thoughts. And this school of thought, sometimes they have differing perspective on how to understand the behavior. So we're going to look at different philosophy, different school of thoughts. Motivation to consume. What motivates you to buy something? What motivates you to consume something? So those are the things that we're going to look at. Technology and culture. What are the influence of technology to our culture? For example, like previously, if you go out with your friends, you're actually talking to your friends. But now, you go out with your friends, all five of you are looking at smartphone, not talking to each other. So that is how technology change our culture. Pergi ke rumah saudara mara, tanya what is the password for your Wi-Fi. That culture. Okay. And then types of consumer behavior studies. Okay, those are different psychology, different school of thoughts and everything. All right. That is the introduction of the whole subject. Okay, the whole subject. Meaning in 14 weeks, we're going to learn about all this. Okay, right. Go to the next slide. So what are we going to study? Consumer behavior is a study of the processes involved when individual or group select, purchase, use or dispose of products, services, ideas or experience to satisfy needs and desires. Again, they're talking about the three processes. Okay, how individual or group select, purchase, use and dispose. Why do you choose Coke, not Pepsi? So those are the things that we're going to learn. Where do you purchase that Coke? Why do you purchase from campuran Coke untuk bersihkan toilet? Okay, so those are the things that we're going to learn. And how do you dispose of the product? Are you recycle the product? Are you just discard the product, or are you you turn the product into something else? Okay, so those are the things that we're going to learn. Okay, according to Blackwell says that consumer behavior is the activities people undertake when obtaining, consuming, and disposing of product and services. Okay, the same thing again. Okay, they're actually talking about the same thing, using the different language or different sentence. Right. Now, disposal. Go to the next slide. Disposal. Why disposal is a hot topic right now? Because it involves environmental issues. For example, just now when I talk about the disposable mask. What happened to the mask when you dispose of your mask at the dustbin? Where does it go? How do you dispose it? Are people going to burn that mask? Kalau bakar, apa jadi? So, asap and all that. Adakah nak guna semula? Tak boleh juga sebab it's contaminated. So what happened to those disposable masks? Is anyone knows about it? Ada orang tahu tak apa yang happened to the mask? Sewerage, for example. Sewerage. If you go to the toilet, you do your business at the toilet. What happened to that waste? And it goes to the system, goes to the sewage system, and what happened to your waste yang awak buang air besar tu, where does it goes? Does it goes to the river? Does it go to the river and pollute the river? Or are you going to recycle that? Okay, it's quite an interesting issue. I watched this documentary. You know that the human waste yang awak pergi kat toilet tu, when you go to the toilet dan awak pergi buang tu, this one documentary says that you can actually, they have done it before. They take that waste and turn it into baja. And that baja, they just use it to their tanaman, their crops, you know that. Okay, so the same thing with food wastage. Okay, Malaysian, I think every day we dispose of tons and tons of food wastage. Maksudnya kita makan sedikit, lepas tu lebih tu kita buang. So what happened to those lebihan makanan, to that wastage? In some countries they use it as compost, they decompose it and use it for crops, untuk baja. Okay, so all this, okay, as a marketer, you see a lot of opportunities, even in wastage. Okay, you got this problem, food wastage, for example. So what do you use with this wastage? So you turn it into different product. For crops, untuk tanaman, jadi baja. Okay, you got, kalau awak buang air di toilet, for example, how do I say in this, okay, tanpa me-offend awak? Because this is recorded. Tu awak punya bahan buangan tu. Bahan buangan. Your human feces, bahan buangan tu. that need to be, it need to go somewhere, okay? You need to go somewhere. But are you going to really waste it? How do you process that? Are you going to discharge it in the river and pollute the river? I don't think so, right? You need to go somewhere. So as a marketer, so you can see a gold mine there, meaning you change that bahan buangan manusia tu into something which is used, which can be sold to farmers sebagai baja, for example, fertilizer. Okay, so those are the things which as a marketer you must understand. Okay, this is a problem and you turn that problem into opportunities. Okay, all right, and any question? Ada soalan? Adakah siapa yang tak faham sebab saya cakap terlampau bahasa yang terlampau sopan? Especially on the human race.
Faham, sir.
Faham, eh? You know what I'm talking about. Okay. Alright. Ada soalan tak? Ada soalan? Before we move on to another slide. Okay, if you go to the slide, it's still talking about recycling the... Okay. How do you recycle your waste? How do you dispose by recycling the waste? And then go to the next slide, consumption processes. Okay, consumption process. Okay, again, we're talking about that processes, pre-purchase, purchase and post-purchase. Pre-purchase is about how consumer decide what she needs, why she needs the product. Why? Because marketing is about creating needs, creating wants, creating demands, correct? So, how do you know that your advertisement will trigger the consumer to buy your product? Okay, last semester, for those who are in my advertisement and promotion strategy class, we know about, when we talk about marketing, when we talk about advertisement, we just advertise. Okay, I asked you to do an advertisement, so you come up with a video to advertise your product, blah blah blah, and all that. But the question is, okay, does your advertisement triggers demands from the consumer to buy that product? So this consumer behavior, we're going to look at the effectiveness of your advertisement. So no longer you're going to craft an advertisement yang short sendiri. Maksudnya awak rasa memang best lah advertisement ni, tapi when you show it to the consumer tengok macam okay, alright, so what? Okay, it doesn't trigger the intention to buy that product. Okay. Then purchase issue on acquiring. How people will acquire that product? Is it through the internet? Is it through a physical store? Then you know, like in this during this pandemic, people so afraid to go out. They may use online purchase. So that is behavior. And that's behavior. Why? Because the current situation, the current pandemic, changes how people buy the product. Okay, it changes the behavior of people buying the product. People so afraid to go outside. Afraid is a behavior. Okay, right now, I can see even for myself, I got this changes of behavior. If things can be bought online, I buy online. If I go outside and I queue to pay for my whatever, let's say cold storage, for example, I buy groceries at cold storage. When I queue to pay for my groceries, I became a bit paranoid when people get so close to me. Maksudnya bila saya queue tu orang berada rapat kat belakang. I feel very paranoid, like macam I'm looking at that person like, hey dude, can you like 1 meter away? Alright, so current situation changes my behavior. Okay, so those are the things which purchase issue that we're going to learn about. And then post purchase, again, how do you dispose that product? So basically for the past 15 to 20 minutes, I'm talking about the same thing. I'm banging on the same point. Okay, I hope that you can understand. All right, so you go to the next slide. Okay, what is behavior? Okay, when we talk about CB, consumer behavior, we talk about cognition. Cognition is thought process. So after this, when you see the terminology cognition, okay, cognition means thinking process, whatever the process in your mind. Okay, when you do thinking, awak berfikir, and that what we call, that thought process, what we call cognition. Okay. Then we could talk about emotion or effect. So whenever I talk about effect, I'm talking about emotion. So these are the terminologies that you need to understand when you learn about consumer behavior. And then cognition. Cognition is effect behavior. Meaning, well, you have a certain behavior, and then you behave in certain ways. When you behave in certain ways, that is what we call cognition. For example, like I am paranoid with the disease. I'm paranoid with the COVID-19. So when people stand very close to me, I become agitated. I become paranoid. So I'm kind of I look at that person and I give this what you call this annoyed face. So that reaction, that emotions that I display is the cognition, the effect behavior. Okay. And then we're going to talk about personal and environmental factors that causes this behavior. And of course, we're going to talk about the behavior. Okay. Okay, if you go to the next slide. Next slide. Then you will see the exchange theory. Exchange theory is something not that important, but something that you good to know, whereby transaction in which two or more organization or people give and receive something of value. It's like exchange theory. Okay, means you give something to get something. You exchange. Okay, tak keluar exam pun. It's just something that you good to know. And then, of course, for the past 30 minutes, I'm talking about identifying the three stages of the consumption process. I've been talking about this for the past 30 minutes. I hope you get what I'm trying to say. Yang about pre-purchase, purchase and post-purchase. All right. How do we divide consumers? Next slide. Okay, how do we divide consumers? This is most important when we talk about segmentation. Okay, in other subjects you talk about market segmentation. How do you segmentize your market? Is it based on demographic? Is it based on psychographic? Okay, we're going to look at that issue again in consumer behavior, but a little bit deeper. Okay. For example, you look at the lifestyle, hobby, values, and persona. This is more of psychographic. You look at the family structure. You look at the family, or is he a family man, or is it a bachelor? For example, like even for family, is it for young family? Kalau young family, the purchase pattern will be different. Young family of young family means husband and wife with two young kids yang mungkin masih sekolah ataupun baru mungkin anak dia umur 1 or 2 years. So the pattern will be different. The purchase pattern will be different. The purchase pattern maybe more akan beli banyak Pampers, akan beli banyak makanan baby, mungkin beli stroller. Okay, those are the punya pattern. Tapi kalau anak dia semakin meningkat dewasa, sekolah for example, so the purchase pattern will be more on barangan sekolah, baju sekolah, buku teks, you know that. Tapi kalau anak-anak dah dewasa, dah bekerja, dan the parent is an old old person, dah tua, anak-anak dah besar dan bekerja, so the purchase pattern will be different. Okay, dia dah tak beli dah Pampers. Okay, mungkin dia punya, dia beli banyak groceries, ataupun dia beli banyak barang food supplement ataupun health supplement. Sebab parents dah tua, right? Kesihatan dah makin kurang, so they need more, requires more of food supplement. Okay, ubat-ubatan, you know that. When we talk about behavior, okay, behavior, how do you predict behavior? This is most important because this is a new thing. Now we use big data to predict behavior. Okay, meaning you can use now big data to predict whether people going to buy your product or not. You use this is software, okay, software. It's something that you wanted to explore because this is something that you can use to help you to predict the behavior of the consumer. What we learn in this subject is all theory, but using big data, using software, you can use technology to predict behavior. You get the technology to do the thinking for you. Right, then you can also divide consumer based on geography. Okay, the locations, gender, characteristic, needs and wants. But now gender is now in our current society, sometimes it's hard for you to predict. Consumer preferences based on gender. Why? Because last time you say that if you got male and female, kalau men they like certain product like sports, you know that. Tapi kalau female dia suka barang-barang yang female suka. Tapi sekarang tak juga. Kadang-kadang men pun yang men tak men, yang female tak female, something like that. The transgender, for example. So ada juga orang lelaki yang tak suka barang-barang lelaki, dia suka barang perempuan. So you need to, that's why I said now gender, if you try to predict consumer behavior based on gender nowadays is very difficult. Sebab dia punya orientation tu mungkin berbeza. Alright. You can predict based on age. Okay, you can divide your consumer based on age. Maksudnya kalau orang tua mungkin macam saya kata tadi, mungkin dia lebih kepada health supplement, medical, you know that. Okay. Race and ethnic, multicultural taste and belief. Okay. And then social class and income. Income and buying power. If you look at the group assignment, the individual assignment just now, social class and income plays a vital role in social behavior. Okay, the inequality of wealth distribution. Okay, whereby the richer become richer and the poor become poorer, and the middle income stuck in the middle. Okay, so it causes dissatisfaction in the society. Okay, the buying power. You see that the top 20 become richer. Okay, they have even during the pandemic they become richer. But the B40 become poorer. So all this buying power involve the income and buying power. Okay, so you need to understand this. So we need to learn about all this. Alright, any question? Ada soalan tak? selepas saya bercakap selama sejam 15 minit? Isn't any question? Hana Bashira, ada soalan tak? Hana Bashira, ada soalan ke?
No sir, I understand.
Oh yeah, okay. What do you understand, Hana Bashira? Apa yang awak faham setakat ni?
Saya faham yang
Awak faham apa, Hana Bashira?
I understand which is consumer is divided with divided in their behavior, family structure, lifestyle, age, gender and others.
Sangat tepat. Okay. Okay, cool, good. Nick Siti Syarah, awak okay ke? Do you following the lesson, Nick Siti Syarah?
Yes, sir. Basically, I love this about psychology, I think.
Okay.
Is it right?
Yeah. So, what causes a student may not be able to understand the subject or find it hard to understand? Because consumer behavior is a little bit psychological in nature. So when we talk about psychology, it's a bit abstract, okay? So it requires you to think a little bit deeper. Itu je, okay? You can't study this subject on superficial manner, meaning you just scratch the surface. You can't. Maksudnya awak baca dan awak kata okay, you just memorize. You can't. Okay, you can't memorize for this subject. This subject is not about memory. This subject is about really understanding the concept, because it talking about the psychological part of it. So when we talk about psychology, it's a little bit thinking behind that concept. You must understand the concept. You need to understand the mechanics of the concept. You need to understand the discussion about the concept, and then you can answer or you can understand the subject. Okay, kalau awak try memory, you won't get it. Okay, you try to memorize, you won't get it. Okay. Let's go to the next slide. The next slide. Marketing impact on consumer. Marketing impact on consumer. It's raining here in Ampang. How about you guys?
Melaka tak hujan,
sir.
Melaka panas.
Panas
eh? Mana? Where are you guys? I'm at Ampang, Kuala Lumpur. And it's raining now.
I'm at...
Dekat Melaka.
Cyberjaya.
Cyberjaya.
Tapak Kuala Lumpur.
No, Khairul, awak kat Ampang ke?
Tapak.
Tapak. Tapak hujan.
Tak ada.
It's raining here in Ampang. It's like saya terkejut for like almost 1 month, January and February tak hujan. Suddenly on the 2nd of March hujan. Quite surprise, okay? Quite surprise. But still, do not forget. Bukan bermaksud kalau hujan tak ada global warming. There's still global warming. There's still climate change, right? But then hujan, okay. Alhamdulillah. Where am I just now before hujan? Okay, marketing impact on consumer. Okay, now, one way for marketers like you and I to learn about the world is to observe on popular culture. Okay, popular culture. What is the meaning of popular culture? Popular culture is something which the trend. Maksudnya culture yang menjadi trend dalam sesuatu society. For example, like I'm not sure about you guys. Okay, in my generation, Star Wars, for example, that is popular culture. The Matrix, that is popular culture. How about you guys? How about your generation? What is your popular culture?
Gadget.
What influenced you? Yeah.
Gadget.
Technology.
Yes, technology.
Gadget such as like smartphone. iPhone is your popular culture, right?
Yes.
Perhaps. Okay, yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm using an iPhone, okay. How about social media?
Yes.
Okay, how social media become a part of your culture?
Maybe it's about influence from different multiple countries dan kita boleh dapat diorang punya point of view and then kita compare dengan point of view kita dengan diorang then from there kita boleh influence yang kita punya point of view lah. Maybe boleh campur.
Alright. But what is the culture?
Maybe sharing information about each other dengan orang different countries.
Okay, culture basically is what a norm or a practice by a large number of people. Okay, kalau macam saya seorang, saya buat sesuatu, saya seorang je buat. It's not a culture. It may be a habit. But if a group of people, a large number of people in that society practicing the same custom, practicing the same practice, so that is culture. Okay, so when we talk about popular culture, is a practice which been used by a large number of people in that society. So that is culture. Okay, so I to tell you the truth, I'm quite out of touch with the current popular culture. That's why I asked you that question. Okay, what is the current or what is your popular culture right now?
Probably nowadays, maybe bukan video game. Video game.
Playing.
Yeah.
So video game become part of your life.
Yep.
Okay. Cool. So, as marketers, how do you use that to your advantage? That is the actual question. Okay. So if you know that is the current culture, so as a marketer, how do you use that in as your marketing strategy, video games? All right. So that is the question. That is the actual question. Okay. Now, role theory, based on philosopher. When we talk about role theory, you look at the consumer behavior resemble action in play, meaning you look at the movies. Okay, you look at the movies, then you are thinking that this world is like a cinema, it's like a movie, and you are the actor and the actresses. And that is the meaning of role theory. That basically a role theory in a nutshell. Okay. Then self-concept attachment means how sometimes you are attached to certain product, sometimes you are attached to certain brand. For example, let's say you go to the pasar raya, you go to the supermarket, you wanted to choose you wanted to buy sardine. What brand are you going to choose?
Ayam brand.
Sardin. Oh, makan sardin tak makan?
Ayam brand, sir.
Ayam brand.
Ayam brand, sir.
Kenapa ayam brand?
But sometimes I buy botan, cap botan.
Cap botan? Aku tak bilang. Okay, alright. Ayam brand. Okay, botan brand. Okay, alright. Kenapa awak choose one brand, not the other?
sebab sampai dia ada kecil-kecil.
Sebab bila setiap kali mak pergi beli barang dapur, dia akan beli barang jenama tu juga.
Okay, so ingrained in your mind that kalau nak beli sardin, cap ayam.
Yes.
Maybe you going out of the norm, you beli cap botan. Lepas ni saya akan pergi ke belakang ke Speed 99 and looking for that botan brand. Now, sometimes you got this nostalgic attachment. For example, like chickadees, for example. Chickadees. I do not know whether you still have chickadees now, but then what I'm trying to say is I got this nostalgic attachment to chickadees. Why? Because when I was young in primary school, after school, okay, selepas sekolah, saya akan keluar from the school gate, pergi kat tempat bas, nak tunggu bas tu, akan ada orang jual makanan ringan. One of the makanan ringan is chickadees. Chickadees. Alright, so kalau ada chickadees akan dijual sekarang, saya akan beli chickadees. Why? Because I got that nostalgic brand. Okay, nostalgic attachment to that brand. You may have your own nostalgic brand. Macam apa? What is your nostalgic brand?
Apollo.
Apollo. Kenapa Apollo?
Sebab time sekolah agama kat Abbas ada Apollo.
So that's nostalgic. Okay, yang memberikan awak kenangan the good old days. Okay, my good old days and you, your good old days may be different. Okay, maybe last time my good old days ialah tengok kartun Thundercat. Sekarang mungkin tengok Agent Ali. Budak-budak sekarang maybe kata Agent Ali. Kalau aku cakap tentang Thundercat, mungkin dia tak faham. Transformers, for example. Okay, Transformers. Kartun Transformers. When I look at Michael Bay Transformers, Michael Bay version of Transformers, aku rasa macam nak menangis. I'm like, Optimus Prime should not be like this. Okay, Transformers shouldn't be like this. It doesn't, Transformers is not like this. Transformers dia macam lain. Okay, aku faham Transformers lain. Why? Because when I was young, when I watched cartoon Transformers, lain. Okay, when I look at Michael Bay's movie of Transformers, dia rasa macam lain. Somehow Michael Bay destroy my childhood bila dia keluarkan movie Transformers. Aku rasa macam Transformers tu being bastardized. That Transformers tu become...
Saya agree, sir.
you tend to agree, right? So it somehow destroyed my childhood. Okay. So maybe that's me. Okay, that's me. Alright. Interdependence and love. Okay, so these are the things which influence behavior. Okay. Now you go to the next slide. What is role theory and how does it help to us to understand consumer behavior? Basically, this is a question. I won't ask you this question because you need to answer. Okay, so you need to go back and do some research. What is a role theory? And how does a role theory to help us to understand consumer behavior? Alright. People often buy product not for what they do, but for what they mean. Okay. The next slide. Okay, what people often buy product not for what they do, but for what they mean. For example, just now, Fifi kata kenapa dia beli ayam brand, because mak dia selalu beli ayam brand. Is that right? This is what you say just now, right, Fifi?
Yes.
So sebenarnya ayam brand tu, okay, ayam brand tu is a symbolic or it reminds you of your mother. You buy ayam brand not because of ayam brand tu sedap. You buy ayam brand tu because it reminds you of your mom.
True.
So you buy product not because of that brand. You buy that brand because what that brand meant to you. It reminds you of your mom. For you, Ayam brand is about your relationship with your mother, with your mom.
Dia macam benda tu kita dah dah guna lama, dah selalu beli benda jenama tu lama. So bila kita pergi kedai, even kita nampak jenama lain pun kita still just macam, oh aku makan ni daripada kecil. So kenapa perlu cuba yang lain? Beli je lah yang ni, macam tu lah.
That's the thing. That's behavior, right? Is that rationale? For example, like if you put Ayam brand and King Cup brand side by side, rationale will tell you you may wanted to buy King Cup. Why? Because King Cup is cheaper compared to Ayam brand.
Okay, true.
Right, and rasa dia mungkin lebih kurang sama, a bit similar the taste. Choose Ayam brand. Tak rasional, kan? So that's behavior. Okay, whereby how do you explain people when people acting irrational, not based on logic, not based on facts. So when just now I thought, okay, maybe you choose Ayam brand because you have that nostalgic moment. It reminds you of your mother. So tak rasional. Kau beli sardin because your mom. Is that rasional? Is it logical? Based on people who based on logic, it may not be logical. Tak logik langsung awak beli Ayam brand ni sebab mak awak. But then if we learn about consumer behavior, we learn about emotions, people are making decision based on emotions. So when you buy Ayam brand sardine, it's totally logical to me. Why? Because it reminds you of your mother. Maybe awak rindu mak awak, awak nampak Ayam brand, now you buy Ayam brand. Something to connect you with your mom. So it's not okay. Based on logic, it's not logic, but if you go deeper based on emotions, then it makes perfect sense to me. Okay, so those are the things that we're going to learn in this subject. Okay, about why people do things sometimes irrational for you. And how do you as a marketer can use this as your strategy on using emotions to trigger buying from consumer. That's why I think when you are in my advertisement and promotion strategy class, you always hear me talking about emotions. You always hear me talking about feelings. Kan? Now you know why. Then when you see me talking pun macam, kenapa dia ni cakap macam beria-ia, macam emosi sungguh dia ni bercakap. Tak boleh ke cakap macam people often buy product not for what they do but for that mean. Tak boleh ke cakap macam tu, that straightforward monotonous. Tapi kenapa dia ni nak cakap beria-ia macam beremosi gila, ada emotions there. Why? Because apart from me being emotions, emotional person, I think people buy based on emotions. Okay, people although people say that they're rational, but people sometimes or most of the time acting ill. Okay, we are always being guided by our emotions. Okay, all right. Let's go on to the next slide. What do we need really? Apa yang kita perlukan sebenarnya? Happiness. My next slide. Do you need happiness? What makes you happy? Bila awak beli sardin cap ayam, does it make you happy? What do you need? Do you need happiness? What makes you happy? Nur Husnina. Nur Husnina. Are you there, Nur Husnina?
No.
Yes. What makes you happy, Nur Husnina?
I don't know.
You do not know what makes you happy? Selama ni, so kalau what you wanted to chill out? What do you do?
Sorry, sir. I cannot.
When you wanted to let your hair down, you wanted to relax, you wanted to reward yourself, what do you do?
Coffee, maybe?
Coffee? So you drink coffee? What kind of coffee? You make your own or you go somewhere? You go to the cafe and buy coffee?
Depends. As long as it's coffee.
So coffee makes you happy?
Yes.
So why coffee makes you happy?
Maybe the aroma, I don't know. But it gives me like chill. Tenang je minum coffee.
You can, there's a lot of things that can give you ketenangan. Ketum, for example. But what? Tak ambil ketum, awak ambil ketum. Just for the sake of argument, right? For the sake of argument. Why coffee and not, why not tea? Why not orange juice?
Because I'm a coffee person.
What makes you a coffee person?
I don't know, maybe addicted dah kot minum coffee. Coffee kan boleh buat orang addict kan benda tu.
Yes. Because they have caffeine. Okay, they have caffeine, right? So it give you some energy and also give, just now you're talking about the aroma. Meaning to say, when people wanted to sell you coffee, okay, what are the things that you're looking for in a coffee? Not just the taste, not any other coffee, but it need to smells good, correct?
Yes. Yeah.
So you actually smell, okay, before you drink your coffee, you smell. You take some time to smell the aroma of the coffee before you drink the coffee.
Yes.
It gives you the satisfaction.
Yeah.
Correct? So that makes you happy. So what makes you happy different from one person to another person? Okay. So these are the things that we're going to learn in consumer behavior. And how behavior affect demand. Okay. These are always the question that you need to ask in this topic or in this subject. Whatever you learn in this subject, we learn about the behavior. You must relate. You must ask yourself, how this affect demand? How can you use this to affect demand? Okay, when you wanted to affect demand, meaning your advertisement lah. Okay, your advertisement. How can you use this behavior in your advertisement? Then we talk about behavior and economics. Next slide. Okay. Micro and macro. Remember when we talk about your individual assignment? How economics affect behavior? That is the answer. Okay. How economics affects your behavior? How economics affects the behavior of the society at large? And how economic affect behavior, the individual behavior, microeconomics. Okay, how does it affect, because economic affect the purchase power. Okay, and then how that purchase power affect demand. All those things are interrelated. For organic food, for example, okay, when we talk about responsible farming, ethical farming, you go for organic food, and you know that organic food is more expensive than normal, katalah awak, you go to pasar raya, you go to the supermarket, you look and you put vegetable from organic farming, the organic farming is much more higher than the normal farming. So how economics will influence demand for organic and non-organic? If you are rich, you have more purchasing power, you can buy organic food. Okay, why? Because although it is more expensive, but you have that. If you do not have that purchasing power, are you going to buy organic food? Are you going to buy electric car? You know that normal car, the fossil fuel car yang guna petrol, is harmful to the environment. But then are you going to buy electric car? You know that electric car is much more expensive compared to the normal car, right? So although you know that the normal car, it is harmful to the environment, but you have no choice. Why? Because kalau nak beli Tesla, for example, awak tak ada duit sebab it's very expensive. The maintenance is very expensive compared to the normal car. So all these are interrelated. Okay, the purchasing power, economics, the environment, blah, 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 blah. It's all interrelated. Okay, it affects your behavior. And how behavior influence your marketing plan. Those are the things that you need to ask. And consumer trends. Okay, trend consumer sekarang. Okay, sharing economy. Last time, I don't think people wanted to share their car with others. But now you have Grab car. Okay, last time you do not want to share your house with others, but now you have Airbnb. Okay, and then authenticity and personalization. Last time during Industrial Revolution is about mass production. Everything, all product are the same, but now you wanted the product to be personalized to fit your personality, correct? Because why you wanted to be feel unique? Awak nak rasa awak dihargai. You are unique, so you need to be personalized. Your product, if you wanted to buy a product, you wanted the product to be personalized based on your personality. Okay, blurring of gender roles. Well, we are now living in the 21st century. Okay, no longer man is superior to woman, gender equality and all that. Okay, so those are the things. Social shopping, this one korang tahulah, beli dari Shopee and all that. Income equality or income inequality, for example. Those are the consumer trends. Healthy and ethical living. Now we are more health and ethical conscious. Simplification. You don't need barang-barang yang terlampau susah nak faham. Kalau barang tu susah nak faham, you don't buy. You need a simple thing. Interconnection and Internet of Things. Meaning now, everything is interconnected. Kan? You wanted to connect between your laptop and your handphone. Senang. You wanted Wi-Fi. Why? Because you wanted that internet connection. Okay. Anonymity. You wanted to be what do you call this? Security. Maksudnya, you wanted to secure your personal data. You do not want people to keep on calling you or selling things. Awak tak suka. It's very annoying. You wanted to keep your personal data. So those are the consumer trends right now. Okay, now chapter summary. Okay, chapter summary. This is summary of what we have learned today. So consumer behavior is a process. Okay, it's a process of which involve individuals or group in selecting, purchasing, using, and disposing of products. Okay, so what we have learned today, consumer behavior is a process. So what are the processes? That three processes. Pre-purchase, purchase, and post-purchase. And then you need to understand the wants and need. Why? Because you wanted to segmentize your product, or you wanted to segmentize your consumer. So to segmentize your consumer, you need to understand what are their wants and needs. Choice. You wanted choice, okay? So marketing activities exert an enormous impact on individuals. And consumer behavior is relevant to our understanding of both public policy issues and the dynamics of popular culture. So understanding consumer behavior, you need to understand the public policy and also the popular culture. When I say dynamics of popular culture, because culture always keep on changing. Okay, the culture in 1780s is different from culture in 2021. Okay, so culture is very dynamic. What else? What motivates consumer? It's very complex. What motivates consumer is changing, always changing. What motivates you maybe doesn't motivate me. Okay. Then next slide, technology. Okay, the function of technology in influencing behavior. So those are the things that we have touched in this evening. Okay, next slide, there are the discussion, homework, blah blah blah. Okay, I'm not going to this. Okay, I'm not going to this. The discussion is good if we are face to face in physical class, then we can do the discussion. Online class is not that good, not very feasible. Okay, and then homework ni, non face to face safe study ni, you don't have to send me the answer. This is for you. This is for you to do. Study. Maksudnya for this you can access guide. Maksudnya awak dapat, awak tengok question ni dan awak jawab sendiri. It's for your own good, for your own benefit. Awak tak perlu share the answer with me. Okay, jangan nanti letak kat Twitter. Syarin letak macam-macam homework lah, assignment lah, group assignment lah. Letak nama aku from Syarin from Uni KL bagi homework. Tak ada hati perut. Tak tahu ke orang ada banyak lagi benda nak buat. So jangan. This homework ni is for you, not for me. Awak buat sendiri. Okay, kalau awak nak buat, buat. Tak nak buat, sudah. Okay, it just a guide for you to do your own revision. Because when we do revision, sometimes we do not know where to start. What are the relevant question that we wanted to ask ourselves for when we do revision? So when I give you this question, so you will be guided. You have a guide on how to do revision. When you try to answer the question, then indirectly you are doing the revision itself. Okay. So no commitment. Okay. No need to push yourself untuk bagi saya the written answer. Kalau awak bagi written answer pun, saya tak ada masa untuk menanda atau memarkingnya. Okay, I got other things to do. This is for your own good. Alright, next week we going to start. We going to discuss case study number one. In your VLE, hi Alexa, what is consumer behavior? So this we going to discuss next week. When I say discuss, I meant discuss, not mini lecture. Okay, meaning to say, you going to tell me what is your opinion on the answer of the case study. Okay, yang ini sila baca before you come to class. Don't lah do the perangai when I ask the question baru nak baca. you won't be able to answer my question. Okay, you just read before coming to the class, understand what is the case study is all about. Just prepare, mentally prepare the answers, and we're going to discuss in class before we move on to the next topic next week. All right, any question? Ada soalan? Zarif Haika, do you have any question? Zarif Haika?
Tak ada, sir.
Alright. You following the lesson?
Zarif? Yeah, following.
Alright. If you don't understand, you just ask me, yeah?
Okay. Yeah, okay, sure. Okay.
Alright. If there's no question, then I'll see you next week.
Okay, sir.
Alright.